Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor, and today I'm talking about supplements that you can take to help to protect you from EMF exposure. So whether that's, you know, from the cell phones, from the Wi-Fis, from the 5G, from anything in your environment that has its own electromagnetic current can have a negative impact on your cells. So be sure to check out our full 1 hour show about this. We have both part one and part two all about EMF exposure. And, you know, the research is coming out and it's coming out hard and fast. And as much as, you know, industry doesn't want us to be talking about this, absolutely as it is a factor and has been proven in over 1,200 studies on EMF, on that radiation and its impact on our health. So what can we do? Well, we can certainly take supplements to help to protect ourselves. And in a previous video, I explained about calcium and how too much calcium getting into our cells through the VGCC, so voltage-gated calcium channels, which are electromagnetically influenced because they are voltage gated on the outside of our cells. This allows for too much calcium to come into and pour into the cells. And this is a problem. It affects our muscles, affects our heart, our nervous system, even our eyes. And it's something that we definitely want to regulate. So what is nature's calcium channel blocker? It's magnesium. And that's why magnesium deficiency, we have a whole show all about magnesium deficiency, why it's so important that we make sure that we're getting enough magnesium. And it's very difficult to get enough magnesium in our diet. Our soils have become so depleted in magnesium. So this is something that absolutely, I believe, in my opinion, needs to be supplemented. And taking the right type of magnesium. So you want to make sure that you choose a magnesium that's highly absorbed. So the one that I take is a magnesium bisglycinate, so bound to glycine. Now glycine is an amino acid, which helps with our collagen levels, but also ensures that rapid absorption and the bioavailability of that magnesium. So to get links to the magnesium that I take, you take a look in the description below. We'll share a link there with whole food supplements and why it's important, again, to make sure when you are supplementing that you're doing it with whole food nutrients that your body recognizes and absorbs. Another one is curcumin. So curcumin definitely helps with our immunity, but also activate something called the NRF2 pathway, and this is our body's ability to be able to turn on its own antioxidant system to combat those free radicals and specifically to combat the EMF exposure and those negative impacts of EMFs on our cells. So curcumin is fantastic. That's the active component of turmeric. And again, you want it to always be standardized to 95% curcuminoids, which is the active component of the curcumin. So again, check in the description below for the links to some fantastic products. Vitamin C. So vitamin C also activates the NRF2 pathway for our antioxidant status, but you've got to be a little bit careful with vitamin C. If you're taking synthetic vitamin C, like ascorbic acid, calcium ascorbate, there's the risk always of, number one, taking too much, but number two, because it's not the same as taking a whole food vitamin C, and of course that's what I recommend taking is a whole food vitamin C if you're going to take a supplement, and if it's not whole food, then you have the risk of increasing too many antioxidants is not a good thing, and they can become like a pro-oxidant or like a free radical within your body when you're taking too much of the wrong type of antioxidants, and vitamin C is notorious for that. So again, you've got to do your research. Yes, vitamin C is good, but it's got to be in the right format, in the right amounts. As well as quercetin. Now, quercetin has been in the news a lot lately. It has an antiviral component. Clinical trials are going into quercetin and its ability to stop viral attachment. And that's really, of course, top of mind for a lot of people in today's day and age. But it also activates the NRF2 pathway. So it's an important antioxidant, again, that gets our own internal processes going for that antioxidant status. As well as DHA. So DHA has been touted as the most important nutrient that our body needs, hands down. And why is that? Well, not only does it activate our NRF2 pathway for antioxidant status, but it is with combination of water, the battery of our body. It's the battery of our cells, and without enough DHA, our body malfunctions and does not work properly. So we need to make sure that we get enough DHA. Certainly from fish is one way, absolutely, but I actually recommend getting it from supplementation, from a high quality DHA supplement. And this is important because you want to make sure that that supplement has been molecular distilled. There aren't any contaminants like PCBs, dioxins, and the heavy metals, which quite likely were in the fish. And if they were there through that special process of molecular distillation, they have been removed. So again, for links, check the ones down below. And as well as keeping our microbiome healthy. So our microbiome is the good and bad and what's happening in terms of that ecology, the good and bad bacteria in our gut. And we know that the good guys, probiotics, are damaged by EMFs, as well as the bad guys can actually propagate and grow in the event that they are inundated with EMFs. So really important that you take a high quality probiotic supplement, eat as many probiotic containing foods in your diet like kimchi, sauerkraut, kombucha, do whatever you can to get these natural probiotics in your daily diet. But taking a high quality supplement is really important as well. Now, CoQ10 as well as resveratrol is also something that can be supplemented, and in combination with other antioxidants like CoQ10 can be a powerful way to really protect not only your cardiovascular system, but your beauty, so for your skin cells as well, but also specifically protecting against EMF radiation. And the resveratrol also stimulates that NRF2 pathway, which is your body's own internal antioxidant cycling, and that's something definitely that you want to think of. So whether you get the resveratrol from a supplement, or again, you could get it from red wine, and small amounts is okay, but again, with EMF exposure, we don't want to be spiking our blood glucose levels. We want to keep them nice and balanced. So remembering enough healthy fats and using the supplements that I mentioned in this episode to be able to help you to minimize that damage from that EMF exposure on a daily basis, not only for yourselves, but for your children as well, which is something that I spoke about in another video, with our children being inundated with the Wi-Fi signal in the school. Hopefully they don't have a cell phone, but if they do, make sure it's on airplane mode and they never hold it up, you know, to answer a call. And really minimizing exposure is so important for our children because of the link with the EMFs, with ADD, ADHD, autism as well. So thanks for joining me today. That was all about the supplements and EMFs and how to decrease our risk of that damage to our cells. And of course, doing it naturally. I'm Dr. Janine Bowring. Please give me a big thumbs up, leave your questions and comments below, and click your notification bell so that you always get our newest and latest uploads here on our channel. Thanks for joining me today, and remember to always take care of your good health and do it naturally.